Welcome, my dear friends. This is the symbol of the Omega, I think. You can all see that, but it's the Omega sign on upside down. Normally it's like this, and now it's like this, but maybe if you go a little bit back, then this sign can be seen also. Ancient times, the Omega symbol was the symbol of the Anunnaki goddess Ninhursag, also called Ninma. She was the sister of Ea, the half-sister of Enki and Enlil. Enki was also called Ea. You can read this information on the so many websites on the internet, and also from the books of Zecharia Sitchin. So the symbol of Ninhursag, the goddess who created humanity, she stands for fertilization of human humanity, but also for population reduction programs that the Anunnaki conducted on humanity. Very sadly for humans who have to undertake such a fate. But perhaps if humanity dedicates itself to love, wisdom and enlightenment, these kinds of projects are not necessary. We hope so. The Anunnakis created humanity 300,000 years ago in Mesopotamia, in where now is Iraq, and the astronauts from Nibiru who came here 445,000 years ago with spaceships from Planet X or Nibiru, they created humanity in their image and after their likeness. So the Alpha symbol in the Bible and the Omega symbol, which you also find in the Holy Scriptures, is the beginning and the end symbol, the symbol of the arrival on planet Earth from the planet of the crossing, which has the Alpha symbol, which also is used in Christianity as the Pisces symbol, the Alpha and the Omega symbol, which indicates the end. That's all traceable in the Sumerian clay tablets and the Bible and the Enuma Elish. It's the creation of our solar system, the creation of our planet and the life on earth and the creation of humanity in the final stadium of the Enuma Elish. Well, the end is not indicating the end as an end as we have been taught, but it's the end of an ancient cycle and a new beginning, a renewal actually of time. So you can see why the omega symbol is almost a circle over here, because the end is only the beginning of the new, the point in time of renewal. So it all starts where it ends. The end is the beginning. So as has been said, the last things shall be the first things, and the first things shall be the last things. And perhaps those who came on earth will be probably the last to leave. I wish you all the best and the luck and the love, and join me next time. Thank you.